Lambert, the guy's about to turn blue. We're breathing again.
Okay, we've had a problem here.
Wow, well, we all know that famous phrase from the Apollo 13 mission.
Yes, we do definitely remember that phrase from the mission. And of course, it was Houston, we have a problem. The astronauts were talking to a team, including NASA warning system engineer Jerry Woodfill. And he was also on the job 50 years ago this week for Apollo 11. Woodfill is a NASA legend who played a major role in getting man on the moon. And we are so honored to have him with us today to share some of these amazing memories. Mm-hmm. First and foremost, thank you so much. And thank you for your service for all of us in our country and what you've done with NASA. Truly is an honor to see you. And correct me if I'm wrong here, you're the only one who has held this position since you were 23 years old. Is that right? We're talking
about
54 years.
That's true. I started at the age of 22. NASA hired me, and I guess nobody actually wanted the job. So I became, by default, I got the job. And so I was the alarm system engineer for the Eagle that landed on the moon, as well as the Columbia that took the astronauts out there. And I came from Rice University. NASA made me an offer I couldn't refuse, the only one I had.
There you go.
So I found myself thrust into the whole arena of actually putting a man on the moon. Now, John Kennedy had spoken in Rice Stadium, and I was there. Mm-hmm. And I was a struggling basketball player, mm-hmm. as well as a struggling student. But I listened to John Kennedy, and what he said motivated me. He said, you know, we do this thing not because it's easy, but because it's hard.
Yes.
Well, that was what I was going through. It wasn't easy to get a good degree at Rice University, but I left the stadium with a new power within me, mm-hmm. and because of that, I focused on my studies. I actually graduated. See, you can see that.
I
have a
Rice
ring right here.
He does have the ring. I love that.
So, you had a hard job, too. And I want you to take us back to those famous words we heard, Houston, we have a problem. What was it like, especially a guy in your 20s there with this big pressure of hearing something like that?
My difficulty was, as the alarm system engineer, to make sure that the vehicle didn't turn on what we called nuisance alarms. You know, when your engine light comes on, mm-hmm. and you take it to, you can't reproduce it. My problem was, I hope that it's a real alarm, that it isn't something that's just a nuisance. Mm. And that was my first thought. But then Jim Lovell said, we see something venting in this. Oh, I said, my alarm system was the first alert, the first warning that got everybody on top of the problem. That Houston was having a problem.
So basically, almost to the point, may have saved their lives because you were the one who was monitoring this and you saw that, yes, there really is something going on and alerted the most important
people. Well, that may be a little bit of an inflated view.
I'm just telling the truth.
I was part of the team, and the team received the Presidential Medal of Freedom. You know, Gene Cranston, I've got the president as a part of that team. And so for the next 4 days, we wrestled with all kinds of difficulties. Now, if you've seen the movie,
I have.
You see where they took that square filter,
yes.
and they used
duct tape. Yep.
Well, that was our group. We were called the Mission Evaluation Room, not flight control. We were the engineers that actually designed things, tested things, made sure they worked. So we were created after the Apollo 1 fire to be kind of looking over the shoulders of flight controllers and astronauts, because we were the guys that created the thing. Mm-hmm. So it took three groups, the astronauts, the flight controllers, and the engineers, to bring Apollo 13 safely
That's
home.
Amazing.
But to be in that moment, though, mm-hmm. just knowing that life and death was just on a strand here, I mean, what was that like just going through your head?
Well, we'd been trained. You know, I had spent all kinds of time. And so what happened to me was, my first concern was I had not done the right kind of a job.
Yeah.
You know? And I said, if that's really terrible, mm-hmm. because if I hadn't done the right job, told them the right thing, you know, I could be responsible for them losing their lives.
Yeah.
So those are the kinds of things that were running through my head, that I had to know that I had done the right thing, that because I hadn't done a proper job, I could be responsible for the actual loss of life.
Yeah, well, you did the right thing. That's why they were able to get home safely. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the subscribe button to see more videos just like it. Thanks for watching.